This is serious. We have to learn how to control inputs in our spreadsheets. Mistakes cause problems. They invite a lot of questions. And when we can control the inputs, we keep crazy stuff out and we maintain the integrity of the data that we allow in. Let's check this out. Now here, we've got some data about programs and our funding is tied to this data. We've got kids' names, ages, and the number of days they were absent. We know we only deal with kids from 8 to 12, so we should not have a 5 or a 19 or a J in this cell. So let's look at this. Andrea, age. So I go to type a 9 for Andrea, but I accidentally hit I. Excel should not take that. So let's delete that. Now, I'm going to highlight the entire column. In the Data tab in the ribbon, Data Tools, Data Validation, Allow Any Value? No, that gets the forensic accountants to show up. Hit the drop-down list, Whole Number, Between, Minimum 8, Maximum 12. We can put an error alert. If somebody puts in something crazy, we're gonna have the message, you know better than that, exclamation point. Okay, now, Andrea, I accidentally type I, enter. You know better than that. Cancel. So now, Andrea is 10 years old. Great, it took the 10. With data validation, you can control a lot. So go in there and check it out. You can control dates. You can control certain text. You can control whether something is an integer or a decimal. The bottom line, though, is you need to get to know data validation so that you can keep the crazy stuff out of your data.